So we have to sell that type of people mostly to get profits in the industry.
So now you become a data scientist very soon. Okay, so yeah, I think now you got an idea, right? So it's completely different from a regular project. So it's an iterative model, basically. If you feel somewhere, for example, if your results are not, your predictions are not that good, if you're not so successful in getting proper predictive analytics, you go back again, you started with the problem again. You come back till here. And even after prescription, still you're not getting again, you go back. So this is a iterative process until the business is set. Yeah, so business, is really satisfied, you know, you can keep on doing this actually. So,
I was just curious, like in the clinical trial scenario, like for example, there are different, for example, how you take the Ayurveda medicine is different. Like you have to take it on empty stomach or you have to take it after breakfast or dinner.
Right.
So are these the outcomes of clinical trials? I mean, I was...
No, not exactly. Okay. So they store all these details technically, it's very too technical. So I just, you know, made it simple to make you understand. But actual details are, you know, what are these, you know, sodium levels in the body? What is your, you know, NaCl, I mean, levels. So they'll record everything. So that is too technical. Okay, so they also see the, what are the timings when they have to apply a drug. That's definitely for sure. While you are sleeping.
Right.
So when they apply this drug, what could happen? Because most of the body is unconscious. So they have all these details. Those details are available.
So maybe basis that parameter, they say that before, like on empty stomach, these parameters would be such, and therefore advise it like that.
Right, right.
Okay.
Right. So similarly, even disease prediction is also one more section that's completely different. It's not the clinical trials. There also, what is the subscription? What is the prescription doctor has given, and how, you know, what is the next when he is going to go under a particular he is going to get, there is 90% chance that the patient can get a fever.
Right.
They'll predict it actually.
Right.
So based on the past information, so they've been collecting these details. Right. So doctor prescriptions and, you know, reports, everything will be captured. And this is after applying the drug. So this is not at all related to clinical trials.
Okay.
So this is a general operations side ML, I mean data science. Okay, so next I think you can continue.
You have to identify the expiry dates of products. This is all used, like when it stops working. So that's what they do. Like I made a drug and in 10 days and in 15 days like that, at different points we measure if it's affecting the patient or not.
Right.
Based on that we come up with what the expiry date of the medicine will be.
Right, so there is a data science powered success story. Again, can you continue?
Yeah, so it's a story of Uber. It's not like a new problem they have solved, but they have solved the same problem with differently, that's it. Okay, and they have become successful. So the problem they identified is the taxis are there and people are there, but there is no connection for taxis and people, and also the meters were tampered and unreliable, and finding the cabs were challenge and so on. Okay, and there were safety issues, language barriers and so many things. So this is the problem that was identified, and the solution is create a mobile app, okay, to connect the drivers to the customers. And so to get competitive advantage, so there were already these applications earlier, and also telephone support and so on by Meru and other cab services. Okay, but how will they get a competitive advantage? They should cut their costs, okay, and target more audience. Okay, that's where data science was used. Okay. So how to cut the cost is what is the best route the cab should travel in. Okay, and let's say from A to B, that could be the best route. But after I go, I mean, even for allocation, cab allocation, if I go to B, if I don't provide the driver more rides, like the customers are very few in that area in B. Okay, maybe that's not the route I want to send most of my cabs to. So Meru didn't had all these information, and it was not analyzing this data, but Uber started analyzing this data, and yeah, we know how it has grown, In just 10 years, it has become multi-billion dollar company. Okay, so they have expanded their business and they have become multi-billion dollar company. So yes, that way data science is very important. And what did Uber do? So these are like in several places they have used data science. So in real time pricing, demand forecasting, competitor analysis, like what other like Ola or Meru are doing, analyzing that data, and optimal routing, maintenance, incentive, what is the incentive they have to give to the drivers and also customers. So when Uber has launched, they used to have lot of offers for customers. Okay, and they are not like always uniform. Sometimes it will be targeted segments, like in Hyderabad they will run one program but not in Bangalore. Okay, so it's different in different cities and different for different age groups and so on. Okay, and also credit risk prediction and market, new market analysis if they want to expand in new markets, like in India we started and we want to expand to other countries. For that we have to identify, do a analysis of the market. And also, yeah, this is more like a customer relationship. So continuously monitoring the rating and the feedback and taking actions on drivers, like if there are bad drivers, identifying them and not giving, I mean, they giving them lesser incentives and so on. Based on so the customers will have good experience. And also the customer support is totally automated. So I don't think they have any number where we will be calling them. It's totally,
I think by app messaging,
yeah, messaging in app, and most of the responses are done automatically also. If it's not like a high risk one, like immediately they refund if it is some small amount. Otherwise, only manually there will be some intervention. So there is a bot support kind there.
So basically, a data scientist should think in the perspective of the businessman, like as if he is owning Uber, for example. So when we are starting with a business problem, so we have to think wherever we should identify the places where we can actually apply ML.
Yes, yes. And also when we start a business, any business, we should identify, I mean, we should stop all the data leakages. Like we want to capture every data point. Okay, so we have to identify from where we are getting data, and we should be building a system to capture that data so that we can use it for intelligence. Okay, yeah. So how to spot a business idea? This is one very simple problem. So given some data, how to analyze some basic analysis and identify what problem we can solve. Okay, so yeah, so if you see the life expectancy in several countries is like that, and what could be the reasons? Any guess? Okay, so yeah, because if you see in the developed countries, doctors per patients is higher when compared to developing and underdeveloped countries. Okay. And also the GDP per capita, like how much money a person earns. Okay. So that's also varying hugely. So these are the two major factors. Like if you see, it is very directly correlated. So these are higher, high to low, and these are also kind of high to low. Similar pattern you see there also. So these, so from here, what can we analyze? So people are hesitant to spend lot of money for the doctors here in at least India. That's our experience. Like if we get fever, we'll just think that, okay, I'll take some paracetamol and sleep. And we avoid doctors. Okay, because we have to spend money, and also to waiting time. Like if you go to a government hospital, in private hospital it's still fine, but if you go to a government hospital, there will be huge queue, hundreds of patients waiting for single doctor. So for a simple treatment, you will have to spend your entire day. So we avoid going to doctors even because of that.
Even for private hospital, it's not like that only.
Yeah.
Doing a big queue for to get the medicine.
Yeah.
But obviously, that is what the direct impact is the number of physicians per hour only.
Yes.
Per 1,000 only.
Right.
That is a basic problem.
Correct. Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, what can we do with this? Any business ideas which we can think of?
So it's like number of physicians per 1,000. We can't really do about the population, right? We can increase the number of physicians probably, or maybe the physicians who are catering to say X customers, if they can cater to more customers given that they are 24 hours in a day probably.
I think almost for 80% of the customers or the patients who are going to hospitals, they are having very basic reasons.
Right.
Yeah, that's where we can automate.
Right, right. So that's correct. So we can actually build some bots. So these days there is a lot of digitization. So symptoms of the patient and prescriptions by the doctors, everything is actually being recorded digitally. Okay. So we can use all that information and create some bots. So primary healthcare bots we can create. So when the patient has when the patient feels uncomfortable, he can enter his symptoms and all that, and the bot can recommend like what is the immediate first aid they should get and what are the tests, probable tests they should get done. Okay, so instead of going to the doctor, now the route is like we go to the doctor gives us the first aid and the the tests to be done, right? So instead of that, the bot can do it. It's a very less risky area. Okay, so once we get the reports, that's when we can actually go to the doctor. Even for that we can actually integrate it along with the doctor's input. So the bot will give the input and the doctor can actually agree or reject or edit kind of features we can build using
feedback.
So that's the business problem. That's the solution actually. Yes. So
indirectly what we are doing is we are trying to reduce the first level consultation.
Correct.
By providing automated suggestions, which are actually powered by doctor's intelligence.
Correct.
Feedback, right?
Correct. Yeah. So. Yeah, we'll be showing some demos now. Like there are several readily usable applications which are built by these big giants like Google, Facebook, Microsoft and so on. Okay, so we can actually use those products off shelf instead of we rebuilding them, unless their performance is bad. Only when the performance is bad, we have to actually develop our own applications. Okay, so we will be showing here some of the demos of the industry applications.